welcome back to another episode of Online Arbitrage. This is where we go online, we search for deals, we find items online. Junk drawer lots is what I found this time that we're going to get into and flip in my eBay stores for big profits. Let's take a look at the unit that I purchased for resale.
All right, here's a look at it. Paid $25 plus shipping. I think the $36 all in. Yep, $36.11 for everything. What I saw on this one, of course, were those patches, and there's a belt buckle there, a couple watches. Let's take a look through this and see what else we can see here. There are those watches. Nice looking watches. Liz Claiborne, I think one of them is, the women's one. One gold tone, one silver tone. We got that Barry Sanders. The legend, Barry Sanders, some sort of Barry Sanders item, some buttons, lots of little collectibles, some pins, some pendants, a little race car there in the back. So there it is, Barry Sanders. I saw three items that were catching my eye that I knew would pay for it. The belt buckle, the Nissan patch, and the Barry Sanders. So there's $30 right there. Everything else we got will be pure profit. So let's take a look at it. So once again, $36.11 I paid for this unit. We're gonna get into this and see what it looks like, see if there are any surprises in here. We saw the pictures, but sometimes you don't see everything in the photos of these. Sometimes there's some hidden gems that you're not expecting. So let's cut this open and have a look. There it is. There it is. Let's pull this out and put it out here on the table for everybody to see. Look at this. The first thing you see there. You guys read that? Don't mess with the U.S. I don't know if that's a little message they sent to us in that package or if that's part of the unit that we purchased, but we're going to get into this, put all of the merchandise here out on the table, then we'll go through it one at a time. All right, let's lay it all out here on the table, and I'll give you guys a look at everything that we have. This is exciting. I see some good stuff in here already. So let's, there it all is. All nice and neat. Let's get into it. So the first item that caught my eye, of course, was this, what we saw on the back, don't mess with the U.S. It looks to be some sort of playing card. It says Rambush, and it has a picture of a bush on there. Not sure if that's supposed to be original or George W, but I think that's an older bush from back in the day, standing on a, I'd imagine it's Saddam Hussein probably. All right, I got it all laid out here. Let's go through it in a little bit more detail. First thing that caught my eye, this was one of the three items I noticed, this little Texas belt buckle, and that's easily worth probably $10 to $15. So there's half the investment back right there. There was this nice Nissan patch. That was another item that caught my eye. Like I said, that Nissan patch. Probably $5 to $10 for that one. And then there were the watches. We'll hold on those watches. But this kind of surprised me. This was a little smaller than I thought it would be. This is that Barry Sanders pin. It's a pin, actually a pin. It's very small. Little pin, Barry Sanders. Obviously there's probably tons of Barry Sanders fans out there, so we could probably mark that $10. I'll have to look it up and see what it's going for. You know, obviously a legend of the game, Hall of Famer. Came back from 1994. This is from 94, so it does have some age. I guess that does make it vintage at this point, or anything over 20 years old. So we'll have to look that up and see if it has any significant value. In addition to that Nissan patch, there were also these two patches here, American Red Cross. Not sure if those have much value. People do collect patches, so I don't put a lot of value on those. I'm not sure if I'd even list them. There's a lot of, you know, stolen valor, I guess, and there's security reasons you probably shouldn't list stuff like that. People could put a patch on a shirt and pretend to be somebody they're not, so we might be a little bit careful and hesitant about doing that. But there was this coin purse. It's a little bit sticky. I don't know if I'm gonna list something that's sticky like that, but there was also this little purse. This might be able, we might be able to list something like this. It says My Rosary. Someone could put their little rosary in there. That's probably worth $5 maybe. I'm just a quick and easy little lister. We do have this little car, a little die-cast car, a little race car. This one is pretty run-of-the-mill, probably not worth too much, maybe a couple bucks. I'm not even sure if I would list it up, but I do collect the cars together, and I'll probably make a lot of cars once I get enough of them. There was this little keychain, not sure if you guys can see that, but it says cross country on it. So kind of a cool little keychain. It has a little number on the back there. I'm not sure if that's anything special, but people do collect keychains. I usually try to lot those up as well, get a bunch of them together and put them up all at once. There were a couple rings. There was this little plastic ring. That's probably not worth much, but it is kind of cool. And then there was this kind of, I'm not sure what you call this, a Victorian style ring. You can see that there. If you search those online, they do sell pretty good, that style. So maybe that's worth 5-10 bucks. There were also some pendants here, three pendants. They look to be religious based pendants. I'm sure you can see that there. That's the first one. And then we have this one here. And lastly, this one here. I'd imagine none of them are precious metals, but we'll have mom double check. My mom worked in the jewelry industry, and she knows when she sees gold and silver. I can usually spot it pretty good, but I'm not as expert as she is. There was one little coin in there. I'm not sure exactly what this is. Probably doesn't have much value, but again, we'll collect these and get a bunch of them together, and then we can lot those up eventually. I wouldn't list those individually unless there's something special, and that one appears to be just something run-of-the-mill. Finally, we have five pins here. Kind of a few cool ones. This one says Chief Steward on it. Chief Steward. Give you guys a look at that one. Chief Steward. And then we have a Dale Murphy. You guys remember Dale Murphy, the star for the Atlanta Braves back in the day? Dale Murphy. I think his son now plays. I don't know if he plays for Atlanta, but he definitely plays. Not sure what this has on it. Looks to be a hand holding something. You guys familiar with that? This one here, again, I can't see it. I'll have to look at these with the scope. They're so small, I can't even make out what they are. But we got some nice ones here. This might be some sort of Boy Scouts. I don't know if you guys can recognize that. Let me know in the comments. So we're down to the last four items. I want to thank everybody for watching. Hopefully you guys enjoy these little online arbitrage videos. We can learn a little bit about what stuff is selling for. You guys can share in the comments, hey Brian, this is worth that much. You know, if you see a gem in here that I don't know anything about, let me know. Hey, that pin's a collectible or something. We got four more items here. Let me show you what we're working with. This one has a $2 price tag on it, so we're gonna take it out of the packaging here and see what it is. It looks to be a nice set of earrings. Let me give you guys a look at those. Some blue stones, kind of gold tone. Not sure if they're anything special. They're at least worth $2. That's what they paid for them, right? So I'd probably mark those up a little bit more than $2. I'd probably look online, maybe mark them. $9.97 is what I like to price my earrings, get them under that $10 threshold. So they did have some additional stones that came loose. It was in the packaging, kind of those little blue stones you saw it in there. One of them came loose, so I don't know if that happened during transport or if they were like that, but not complete, but we do have those stones. Maybe my mom can put those back together and make them usable again. So we're down to the last three items. Of course, those last three are those watches that I told you about. We got some good news and we got some bad news. This one showed up and it has a broken link. Of course, a broken link here. So that will have to be fixed. You know, someone could buy this and put a new watch band on it. But we'll list it up as is. Nice looking watch. If someone wants to do the work and put a new band on that, they could have a nice looking piece. Probably needs a battery and a new watch band, and they could have a nice looking piece. The other two are women's watches. Let me give you guys a look at those. So it looks like this men's watch is a Pulsar. This is a Pulsar watch, and these women's watch, This is a Liz Claiborne. Just looked at this one. A nice looking Liz Claiborne. Needs a battery as well. That's oftentimes what you'll find is, you know, people don't want to put a battery in these, but here's the other one. Also needs a battery. That's a Seiko. Seiko Quartz. So a nice, well-known brands, Liz Claiborne, Seiko, Pulsar, all nice watch bands people would know about. But let me know in the comments, what's your favorite item? Which is your favorite item here? I want to thank everybody for watching. Of course, I'm going to tell you what my favorite item is. You know what my favorite item is, right? Don't mess with Texas, right? This is where the money is, right here. Someone's going to buy that belt buckle, $15. There's half my investment. Anything else I list will be helping me to make that money back, that $36, was it? I think I might have overpaid a little bit for this unit, but we'll get it back. Maybe Barry Sanders will help me make that money back. Collector out there will probably want that one. And we got that nice Nissan patch as well. Let me know in the comments, what would you have paid for this? Which is your favorite item? Which one should I list first? And which one should I avoid listing at all? I don't know. Let me know. So once again, I want to thank everybody for coming along for this episode of Online Arbitrage. We found some good deals here. Like I said, I might have paid up a little bit too much for this one looking at the contents, but I think we'll do all right. I'll get some of that stuff listed, make my money back, and then we'll be into the profits. Those pins are a lot to take a little bit to list those, so there'll be some stuff that I won't list and some stuff that I will, but check out my stores, visit my vlog. I do a daily vlog. If you haven't, please consider subscribing, follow my daily journey online. I'm doing more of these online arbitrage videos, so you'll want to come back and watch the rest of them. Make it a regular thing. Come on back, ring that notification bell, that way you can become aware when they drop. Thanks again for watching. We'll see you on the next one. Bye.